Hi, as we all know, October is celebrated as Breast Cancer Awareness Month all around the world in order to increase the support and the attention that is required to create awareness regarding this disease so that early detection and treatment is possible. Breast cancer is the most common cancer which affects women all around the world. According to a report by WHO, 1 in every 10 Indian women suffer from this disease in their lifetime. And 50% of these cases are such that they are diagnosed at a very late stage, so that then the treatment is not possible. But the silver lining here is that if breast cancer is detected in an early stage, then the treatment is possible and cure rate is almost as much as 100%. So now, if we know the fact that this is a most common cancer which affects women, and also it is completely curable if it is detected early, it is very important that we create awareness regarding this disease and we look out for signs and symptoms. We take our own responsibility and do our self-examination and look out for any changes that happen in your breast so that you can meet your doctor at the right time and get the treatment at the right time. So what are the risk factors for breast cancer? Any woman is at a risk of breast cancer because of her hormones. Secondly, increasing age is also a major risk factor. Another risk factor here is that if you have a family history of any similar such disease in your family. As is seen in most of the cancers, any family history or genetic predisposition to a certain cancer can also increase your risk overall. Another important factor is your lifestyle. If your lifestyle is such that there is obesity, there is hypertension, diabetes, alcohol and smoking, then again this increases your risk. Any high doses of estrogen or progesterone taken over a long period of time also increases your risk. Also, if you have a personal history of having any ovarian cancer or tubal cancer or peritoneal cancer in the past, then that can also increase your risk. Genetic mutations like the BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations or P53 mutation are also factors which will increase your risk. Now, as you have seen, most of these factors are such about which you cannot do anything about removing those factors. So the best we can do from our side is be responsible and start looking out for any signs and symptoms in our body and start doing self-breast examination. So what is self-breast examination? Self-breast examination is you looking out for the different signs and symptoms on your breast and other areas by yourself at your own home. So the first thing is each and every woman should start self-breast examination at a very early age, probably early in your 20s. The best time to carry out a self-breast examination is 3 to 4 days after your menses get over or in your mid-cycle. And this self-breast examination should be carried out every month. So what are the different signs and symptoms you have to look out for? The first is inspection. You have to stand in front of a mirror and put your hands on your hips and your shoulders should be straight. And then you look for any of the following signs in one or both of your breasts. You have to watch out for any lumps in your breast area or in the armpit area. You have to watch out if there is any skin discoloration or there is any eczema on your breast. You have to watch for if you have any dimpling or puckering on one or both of your breasts. So in short, you have to check for any change in the shape, size and the form of one or both of your breasts. Now another thing is you also have to watch for any discharge from your nipples. So this is a part where you have to look and observe. After the inspection part is over, then you have to palpate yourself. So when you are examining your breast yourself, the most important thing is your position. You have to lie down, that is in a sleeping position. You have to keep a pillow under one of your shoulders and you have to keep your right hand like this behind your shoulder. and then with your left hand you have to start palpating and feeling your right breast. So how do you carry out the palpation or feeling any lumps or swellings on your breast? You have to feel with the flat of your hands. You should not feel it like this, otherwise you will feel a lot of lumps in a lot of places. You have to feel it like this. So if this is your breast, then you start palpating it like this using the flat of your hand. So what are the different directions in which you should be palpating? The first is going up and down. So you go up on the whole area of your breast and then come down. Like this, you cover the whole area of your breast. A second is you go in and then you go out. Lastly, you have to move your hand in circular motions. So keep palpating and moving your hand in circular position, and then do not leave any area on your breast. If you find any lumps and swelling, then this is your time to go and get it checked by a doctor. After you examine your breast, on the same side you also have to check for any lumps or swellings in the armpit area in a similar fashion. After one side is over, you have to do the same on the other side, and then later on, after examining in the sleeping position, you get up and then you examine either sitting straight or you can examine standing straight. So like this, the main thing is you have to find any lumps or swellings in all of these areas. Also remember that you have to carry out this self breast examination every month. So if you find anything suspicious in the self breast examination, or if you have any constant pain in your breast, then you will go to your doctor. First, most women first prefer going to a gynecologist. So when you go to your gynecologist, we will first carry out triple assessment of your breast. So the first is we will examine your breast for any swellings or lumps in the breast area or in the armpit area. Now after that, a mammography is carried out, and then later on a breast sonography is also carried out, which will be done by a breast specialist. So later on, if needed, the breast specialist will also get an MRI done or the different blood tests done to detect for any breast cancer changes. And lastly, if there is a high suspicion of breast cancer, then it is confirmed by a breast biopsy or an FNAC. It is a very small procedure, which is done under local anesthesia, and the report is available after 24 to 48 hours. So the key here is early detection and early treatment. It can save a woman from any grave progression of this disease. So as I said earlier, breast cancer, if detected early, then the cure rate is very, very high. But sadly, we Indian women are so engrossed in taking care of our family and our children that we tend to put our health the last. So, but I think we can all agree that, you know, if you have to help others and take care of others, we ourselves need to be healthy first. So the one thing we can do about being aware regarding our breast health is carry out a self breast examination every month, starting in your early 20s, and when you turn 40, later on you should carry out a mammography every 2 years, or you can consult your gynecologist or your breast specialist in that case, and they can suggest you as and when to get a mammography or breast sonography done, just for prevention. This self-breast examination and or mammography is to be continued till the age of 70 to 75 years. So in this month of October, let us take pledge to take care of our health and well-being and build small but significant habits in our life, which will make our lives very much healthier.